Yo! Finally. Today is day 3. Hello guys, welcome to Life From. My name is Manu. And so, today is day 3 of 100 push-ups. Today is day 3 of 100 days of daily posting. Like, I think I was actually used to day 3 of 100 push-ups a day. Yeah, today is day 3 of 100 videos in 100 days. Daily posting for 100 days. So today is day 3. And welcome to Life Pro. So today's a story time, and today's story is actually also a precaution for the people who live in Nakuru. I'm from Nakuru. Even currently, I'm in Nakuru. Yeah, in Nakuru. By the way, my set looks nice today. Yeah, today I have a camera. Yeah, today we have a camera, and it looks nice. It brings out the blue light. There's a blue light here. Yes, and so guys, today, as I said, is a story time, and the story I want to share is also a precaution to the people of Nakuru, because it's about how I've almost been conned five times. I've almost been conned in Nakuru, and funny enough, all these 5 times the people are using the same tactic. So this is actually a tactic that is being used a lot of times in Nakuru, and so that's actually the reason why I decided to actually share it out. And so that's what I'm going to be talking about today. And so this is actually like 3 years ago. I think the first one happened like 3 years ago when I was in campus doing my diploma. And so I'm just from school, because our school, St. Paul's University, is just next to town, just at the outskirts of town. And so for me to go home, I actually need to go to town, pick a bus so that I can actually go home. And so what I did, I'm just on my way to town. And so just walking in town, personally, if you have ever walked with me, or if you have seen me walking, I walk fast. I walk fast all the time. And so I'm just walking normally. In my bag I have my laptop, I have 2 mobile phones, one for recording, and the other one is the one that I use for recording, and now my laptop. And so I'm just heading to the stage. And so walking, in front of me I saw a guy. A guy was now walking in front of me. He's in a suit. And so I was like, wow, I wish I'll also wear a suit one day. But now, looking at this guy, the suit doesn't look that good. Down, looking at his feet, he's actually wearing, we call them akala. Akala is this, like, it's slippers or shoes made from tires. Like, yeah, he's wearing akalas and now the suit. And so I was concerned. Then looking back, another guy in a suit is behind me. Okay, and so what I did, because I'm walking fast, I walked fast, I passed the front guy, but then he started walking faster, he came and passed me, then I passed him, and so it looked like a game, and so I decided to actually stop, to walk slowly. I let him actually just pass, and so he passed and went ahead, and so he went ahead and reached a certain point in between some cars. And so what he did, he removed his phone from his pocket and dropped some money. And Manu, at this time, Manu has not taken lunch. Manu, all I have is just transport. That is 40 shillings to go back home. And he dropped some money. And before I realized that he has actually dropped some money, the guy behind, you remember I told you there was a guy behind also in a suit. The guy behind came, overtook me, and he came and picked the money. And he wanted to go, but he saw, he realized I've actually seen him collecting the money. And so he actually told me, Usmami, don't tell him. And so, okay, I was silent. But 3 seconds later, the guy who dropped the money came back. He came back and he came directly to us. Like, he did not go to any other person. He came directly to us. And he was like, guys, see, I've actually dropped some money here. Have you seen my, I don't know if you have actually seen, I've dropped some money here. And so for me, I was like, it's this guy. Tell this guy to give you, because he's the one that has collected. And so the guy gave the first guy money. his money back. And so the first guy wanted to go, but then the second guy was like, ah, wait, check it, brother. No, you can't go without giving us something. Like, you actually have to, yeah, to give us some chai. We call it yamacho for eyes. Yeah, you have, you actually have to give us some money so that, because we have actually helped you. But for me, I was not, no, like, for me, provided you have your money, you can now go. And so the guy was like, no, you have to give us some money because we have actually helped you. But then the first guy started saying, ah, no, you know, this money belongs to my boss. I've actually been sent. And so I need to actually take the parcel that I've actually been sent. I need to take the money there. Then they started arguing, the two of them. For me, I'm just walking slowly, walking to the stage. They started arguing, ah, no, see, you have to give us something. But then the guy then changed his mind. The first guy now changed his mind and told us, see, let's do this because this money belongs to my boss. Let's go to my workplace. I go give my boss his money. Then in my bag, I have some money. I'm going to give each and every one of you 2,000, 2,000. I think 2,000, 2,000 is like how many dollars? $20. I'll give each and every one of you $20. That is 2,000, 2,000, $20, $20. And yeah, I think that will be fine. 2,040, I think that's not bad. So for me, I think immediately he said that he's immediately he said he'll give us 2,040. I remembered the money that he actually dropped. He dropped a bunch of 100 shillings notes. Now, you dropped 100 shillings notes, but now you want to give me 2,000 shillings, yet you dropped 100 shillings note. So it clicked immediately in my mind. I became suspicious. And so he told us, yeah, let's go to my working place. Yeah, for me, I just told them, no, I'll not go. For me, I'm just okay. Go give this guy my money. Yeah, that 2,000 that you wanted to give me, just give this guy. For me, I'm just okay. Provided you have your money, I'm just okay. And so they started now, like, they started begging me, no, let's go. I want to give you 2,000 shillings for tea. Okay. Like, now you're forcing me to give me money. Yeah. Initially you said that the money belongs to your boss, blah blah blah. But now you are now forcing me to come take your money. And so for me, I just told them, no, I'm just good. I don't want your money. Provided you have received your money that you actually had lost, that's good. That's good with me. You don't have to pay me anything. And so I just left them there. And yeah. I know that was the first time, and that is just God. That is just God that saved me from that. And now let me tell you guys, that was the first one. I've encountered that, actually not five times, six times. The other one happened last week. Like, I don't know, actually another time I was still coming from school. I think if you have a laptop in your bag, Someone will just notice that bag is actually carrying a laptop. And so I think another time they still saw me somewhere in town walking. And during this day, I was completely broke. I had no transport. I had not taken lunch. I had no transport. I'm actually walking home. And then the guys just appeared again. And now these guys this time, they came and dropped 50 shillings notes. It's actually, normally it's not 50 shilling notes, it's just like a paper or like a cotton and then covered with a 150 shilling note. And so the guy dropped, immediately he dropped, I actually beat a corner, nilipiga corner. I actually took a corner, yeah, and I just crossed the road to the other side of the road. And then the two guys now were like, brother, where are you going to? See you come, we share this money. Ah, but for me, I think, since the first day, I just realized that is a tactic that is being used. They come drop money in front of you, and then they tell you, let's go here and share this money. And that is a tactic they are using. And I think, actually, many people, I believe, have actually fallen prey to that. Yeah, because we want that 2,000 shillings for tea. You now end up losing everything that you have. Even the 10 shillings you had to buy tea, you end up losing even that. Yeah, and so that is one of the things that I actually thought as a concern I need to share with anyone in, not only in Nakuru, I know each and every place, each and every city has its own conmen and they have their own styles. That is just one style that I have personally experienced six times. Even last week, as I said last week I was actually moving, going to the stage down. And so And they were like small boys, I think 13 years and 14 years. The first boy is walking in front of me, the other guy is walking behind me. And so what I did, actually for last week, what I did, I realized it's the same game. And so what I did, I actually, my dad called me, coincidentally, he called me. And so I picked the phone and I stopped. Immediately I stopped to pick the phone. The first guy noticed that I've actually stopped. And so he also stopped and picked his phone. The second guy came and stopped and crossed the road and went to the other side. And so as I'm talking to my dad on the phone, he's on the other side just pretending to look at me, pretending that he's also waiting for someone. Yeah. And they're just small boys. And so that is just a precaution to anyone in any city, be it Nairobi. Like, thieves are not only in Nairobi or in Las Vegas, I don't know where. They are all over. And so it's just God who actually takes care of us and he keeps us safe. Yes, and so that is day 3. Thank you so much for joining me in day 3 of 100 push-ups. No, I don't know why I'm saying 100 push-ups. Day 3 of 100 daily video posting. Yes, day 3. This is day 3. We are now remaining with 97 days. Thank you. Remember to subscribe down below, and by there you will be hearing a lot of that. I don't know what's wrong with that hen. Each and every time I'm recording, that's when it actually thinks of crowing. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. See you tomorrow in day 4. My name is Manu. Bye-bye. And it's now our time to go. I want you guys to see how nice this light looks like. Yeah, that's the blue. Bye-bye.